But last summer, I had a jar of pickled beets I could not get enough of.
Hey.
Hey, where's your beets?
They're right over here.
What kind are these, Lauren?
Has anybody cut one yet?
Yep, chauga.
Also called a candy stripe beet. What's our first step?
Cook them just like that.
Oh, okay. Show me something.
We don't need to take the greens off.
No, if you do that, you might as well throw them away.
Last year, we went to Crooked Fence Produce, Matthew's produce stand, to have some butter beans shelled. And on the way out, he gave us a jar of his pickled beets and said, these are the best pickled beets you will ever eat. And I said, whatever. And
but then
we got in the car and opened it up. And it was, in fact, the best pickled beet I'd ever had. But I have never seen anyone do what he's doing over here, putting the greens in the pot.
That's the reason. If you cut that off, it's gonna bleed out.
Mm-hmm.
These will be bright.
Because you leave the green, all the green on there.
That's the key.
I guess then you don't believe in eating the beet green.
No, I don't. Do you?
I do.
Do you eat the leaf? Oh, well. Mm.
And we're just gonna put that on the stove. All right, so we'll just wait for it to boil.
I cooked salad Saturday night. Boss got me some pastry.
The boss?
My wife.
Oh.
My wife.
When did it first occur to you to leave the greens on top?
My brother-in-law moved his mother in beside me, between us. I didn't never like beets. And I was out in the yard one day, and she said, Matthew, you don't enjoy beets? Well, you know, you take it. I said, yeah. Well, that night we was eating supper. I said, let's just try them. So I opened them beets up. I go, I said, good God almighty, man. I've been missing this. Well, then I said, I got to know how to cook these things. The ones I'd seen cook, people cut the tops off. She said, they're bleeding out. She said, that's the whole secret. The boss does most of hers pressure.
Pressure? A little scary.
Because of time. She ain't. I had one blow up my ass one time. I'm cooking a hog here. That was a mess. I walked in, it was dripping from the ceiling. That thing had blowed up. Hog head. We was cooking souse. You like souse?
I do like souse.
It's good.
Not on the ceiling.
Well,
souse on the ceiling. All right, Matthew, we've got soft beets, so we've got vinegar. I'm gonna do 1 to 2 vinegar to sugar.
Oh, no, I wouldn't do that.
So you don't put any pickling spices or anything?
This is it.
Okay. Okay, so we'll strain these.
Yeah.
Y'all make a great team.
We do. We need one.
So how do you peel?
Just take it all off.
Do they go straight in there?
Mm-hmm.
Woo! Telling it hot. Woo!
I know that leaving the top on makes it a beautiful color. Do you think it affects the flavor?
I do.
Well, that is a big circle.
No, so vinegary.
Woo!
We ready?
Ready.
Here we go. One jar.
Yes, enough.
Okay. Now, we are going to process these in a hot water bath for 10 minutes. So that would mean submerging them in boiling water and have at least a half an inch of water above them. And that's to kill bacteria and prevent botulism. And also, I think really the biggest safeguard is when you open it, and it smells bad or it looks bad, it is bad.
Yeah, you don't eat it.